Right, we are going to graph the parent graph for exponential functions, which is y equals 2 to the x. Remember, this is in the form y equals a times b to the x. So in this case, our a value is actually 1. We don't see the 1. It's the 1 that would be 1 times 2 to the x power. So first thing we do is what we did yesterday. We have to evaluate the function for different values of x. So we have, let me see if I can write here. Yes. So we have, this is going to be actually y right here. So x comma y. We substitute negative 3 for x, you get 1/8. Substitute negative 2 for x, you get 1/4. Substitute negative 1 for x, you get 1/2, and so on. So now what we're going to do is we take the x and the y coordinates, and we're going to plot those points on our graph. So let's do that now. All right, so I plotted the points in green, and you see we have a curve here, and as you go left to right, this curve is increasing, right? As x gets larger, y gets larger. And it goes up pretty fast, right? It's doubling each time. It's going up twice as fast. So it's going to be a curve that goes, it gets extremely steep, but even though it gets extremely steep, it's still going to the right. So x is still approaching positive infinity, right? Now what happens when we go left? Well, it's going, getting smaller. I don't want to say decreasing, but it's getting smaller. It's going half each time, right? So it's going to be a half, a half, a half. So when we got down here to x is negative 3, got 1/8. You go to negative 4, it's going to be 1/16. Go x is negative 5, you get 1/32. So it gets very hard to graph those the details of those points, right? So will it ever hit 0? Will it ever get to 0? The answer is no. It's going to be so close to 0, but yet so far. So what we have is going to be called a line, which is going to be called a horizontal asymptote. And in this case, in this example, that horizontal asymptote is actually the x-axis. All right. So our curve, now we can finish up our curve. We just connect the points. Comes down, and then I have to put a little arrow there. And that arrow saying it's going up, up, and away, and still going out. There's our exponential curve. All right, so the domain for this function is going to be x equals all real numbers. The range for this function is going to be y is greater than the asymptote, which is going to be y is greater than 0. Okay, for these functions, they're going to be either increasing or decreasing, and sometimes the curve will be above the asymptote. In that case, it'll be y is greater than the asymptote. Sometimes the curve will be below the asymptote. And in that situation, it'll be y is less than the asymptote value. Okay? The asymptote will not always be 0. It will today for our basic examples. But as we progress through this unit, you'll start seeing where the asymptote is at different levels. So you can have an asymptote at y equals 4 or y equals negative 8 and so on. Okay? That's a good first example.